I am Nidhima Manikaram Kumthekar from Yogeshwari Junior College, Ambezovai. I have started topic current electricity yesterday, and in previous topic we have discussed about the electric current I and the important terms related with that electric current, such as current density, which is denoted by J and the mathematical relation for it, as well as a drift velocity, which is denoted by letter VD and the related mathematical relation for it. These things are yet discussed in our previous lecture, as well as we have discussed the Ohm's law, which is the most important law in the current electricity. And in Ohm's law, we have defined the new physical quantity, that is the resistance. And this resistance is nothing but a ratio of volt to ampere, or voltage potential difference to electric current. As I have stated, this resistance is having unit that is named after that scientist, that is Ohm. It is symbolically represented as unit of this resistance is symbolically represented by this symbol, and practically and experimentally its symbol for experimental use is just like a zigzag line. This is the symbol of a resistance. In our last period we have discussed that this resistance of any conductor depends on certain things, that is length, area of cross section, and its material. At the same time, the most important thing on which that resistance depends is temperature. And according to Ohm's law, he has stated that if we keep temperature, material and dimension of any conductor constant, then in that case current flowing through that conductor is always directly proportional to potential difference, and so that will be R is equal to V by I. Already we have defined the unit of this resistance, that is 1 ohm. That means 1 ohm is a resistance acquired by that conductor when 1 volt potential difference applied across that conductor produces 1 ampere current. But actually resistance means the property, it is a property of any material by virtue of which there is opposed to the flow of electric current. So resistance is a property of material by virtue of which there is opposed to flow of current. So this is property by virtue of which there is a flow of electric current, and this resistance can be determined graphically or according to Ohm's law. If we plot a graph between current I and potential V and current I in this way, you will get straight line passing through origin, where theta is angle made by that line with x axis. And from this graph, if we take slope of this graph, it will equal to slope, that means tan of theta, and which is nothing but delta I by delta V. But according to definition, this ratio must be dV by dI for a resistance, so we have to take 1 by slope, which is equal to 1 by tan of theta, which is equal to delta V upon delta I, and which is nothing but a resistance R. And if you take current on this x axis and potential on this y axis, then you may directly calculate as slope is equal to 1 by tan theta and which is equal to r. This is a graph for a certain temperature T. If we plot a graph of for same conductor but at two different temperatures, then that graph will be like this. Suppose this is V and this is R. And if we plot, suppose we have used the temperature T1, then graph will be again straight line passing through origin. It makes angle theta 1 with x axis. And if we change temperature T2, then you will get this graph for temperature T2, which is having angle theta 2. Here, from this graph, this angle theta 1 is greater than theta 2. Here, temperature T1 is greater than temperature T2. As well as, here if we take tan value, means that means we have to take slope, then you will get tan of theta 1 is greater than tan of theta 2. But as I have already stated, this tan theta, that is, if we have to measure the resistance, then that will be 1 by tan of theta 1, 1 by tan of theta 2. If we compare these tan values, you will get 1 by tan theta 1 is less than 1 by tan theta 2. And that means the resistance value will be equal to R1 is less than R2. So this is the relation which will obtain from this graph. Well, again, one thing we have to note that according to the resistance property, which is depending on the temperature of that material, we can differentiate these conducting materials in two types. And these two types are ohmic material, ohmic conductor or material, and another is non-ohmic. Experimentally, it is observed that as we state, the graph between current potential and current is always a straight line, but in practice this is not possible, because after certain increase in the temperature or increase in current, there is increase in the resistance also, because as current increases, temperature increases, and this increase in temperature causes increase in resistance, and the value of current rate decreased, and you will get this graph like this. For this ohmic conductor, this ratio 1 by slope, that is 1 by tan of theta, is R. In case of non-ohmic material, we have to define two, we can measure two types of resistances from this graph, and that is static as well as dynamic. For non-ohmic conductor, this graph never be straight line, but it will be just like a curve. And from this curve, we can determine one is a static resistance. And that static resistance is nothing but only a simple value for a particular value of a particular potential as well as current. So that static resistance R can be determined as V by R. That is, this V corresponding V as well as corresponding R. This ratio is a static resistance. But the another resistance, that is a dynamic resistance, that dynamic resistance can be determined if we take tangent to this graph, then that tangent provides certain angle phi. Suppose this angle is phi, then you may write for that dynamic resistance tan of phi, which is equal to delta I by delta V, and therefore this dynamic resistance can be calculated as R dynamic is equal to 1 by slope, that is 1 upon tan of phi. And for the static resistance, you have to take only the angle theta, similar with this graph. So these two types of resistances we can calculate for non-ohmic resistance. What is mean by ohmic and non-ohmic? The material which obeys the Ohm's law, that is a graph, if we plot a graph between V and I, for that material, if it is a straight line passing through region, then that material is ohmic material. And if the graph between V and I is not a straight line, but it is a curve, and in which this Ohm's law completely not get obeyed, that means that graph is not a straight line, then that material is considered to be non-ohmic. So these are the properties of a resistance. Now we have to consider the another thing, or the another quantity on which this resistance of conductor depends. So we have to here discuss about the dependence of resistance on temperature. Practically, it is observed that resistance of a material depends on temperature, that means any change in temperature causes change in resistance. That means in some materials there may be increase in value of resistance due to increase in value of temperature. Means if there is increase in temperature, value of resistance get increased. But in some materials, increase in temperature causes a decrease in resistance. So these two effects are observed due to this temperature on the resistance of this conductor. Now, which are those materials in which temperature, increase in temperature causes either increase or decrease in resistance? So we can differentiate these materials like this: purely conductor, then a special material, that is magnesium, and semiconductor, in which we observe the different effect of temperature differently on the value of resistance. And if we plot a graph between resistance and temperature, suppose we take temperature on x axis and resistance on y axis, in case of conductor that graph will be like this. Somewhat initially it may be there is a small increase in resistance, and after increase in temperature there is a large increase in resistance. This graph will be observed for conductor. In case of magnet, effect of temperature on this magnet material, you will observe that initially it is having certain value of resistance for even for a minimum temperature, and after that as temperature increases its resistance also get increased. And in case of semiconductor, you will observe graphical representation between T and R, that is a resistance, is like this. There may be increase, if there is increase in temperature then there may be increase in resistance, but remember this increase in resistance is not linear. Similarly, there may also another observation that for which there is increase in temperature but resistance get decreased. This may happen in case of semiconductor. Now we have to mention here the actual mathematical relation for dependence of resistance on temperature, how we mathematically relate resistance as well as temperature. And for that here we have to imagine, let us consider a material or conductor which is having resistance R0 that is a resistance of that conductor at 0 degree centigrade. And if we increase the temperature of that material, then you will observe that its value is get changed. Now RT is a resistance of that same conductor but at any T degree temperature. But here remember, there is an increase in temperature of that material, and you will observe practically that if we take a change in the resistance, that is RT minus R0, this is a change in the resistance. Change in resistance, and experimentally it is observed that this change in resistance RT minus R0 is always directly proportional to its original value, that is R0. Original value of resistance at 0 degree centigrade. And similarly, it is also observed that this change in resistance RT minus R0 is always directly proportional to change in temperature, where delta T is change in temperature. How can we write this change in temperature? That is T degree centigrade minus 0 degree centigrade, that will be nothing but delta T. So, change in the resistance is directly proportional to its original value, as well as change in the resistance is directly proportional to change in temperature. If we combine both these two proportionality equations, you will find that RT minus R0 is directly proportional to R0 into delta T. If we remove this proportionality sign, we will get a proportionality constant, again it is denoted by letter alpha, and equation will become RT minus R0 is equal to that constant alpha R0 into delta T, where this alpha is known as temperature coefficient of resistance. Temperature coefficient of resistance. We can write different forms of this relation. This is actually the first original relation, that is RT minus R0 is equal to alpha R0 into delta T. This is basic first relation. We can write the same relation for different quantities, as if we want to determine relation for this alpha, that is alpha can be written from the same relation, it can be written as RT minus R0 divided by R0 into delta T. So this is also relation. From this relation, we can define this coefficient of temperature coefficient of resistance. According to this relation, we can define it as temperature coefficient of resistance alpha is defined as change in resistance per unit original resistance per degree rising temperature. This constant is having unit, that is per degree centigrade. Per degree centigrade. So this is unit of this alpha. Similarly, the same relation can also be written as, if you want to determine only the value of RT from the same relation, you can write RT is equal to R0 in bracket 1 plus alpha into delta T. This is also relation for this RT. So this is dependence of resistance on temperature. If you know any initial value of resistance at any initial temperature, and if you want to determine any other value of resistance, change the value of resistance at any other value of temperature, then you can use any one of this formula, and for that you have to know the temperature coefficient of this resistance, that is alpha, and that alpha is a constant for that material. Now this is a relation. If we start the resistance value at 0 degree centigrade, but if you have a resistance value R1, this is a resistance of that conductor at any T1 degree centigrade, and you have to determine its value R2, that is value of resistance at any T2 degree centigrade, then we can use same relation for that, and we can determine either value of alpha in this case, or we can determine any that change the value of resistance at that particular temperature T2 by using same relation, that is alpha in this case can be written as R2 minus R1 divided by R1 into delta T, means T2 minus T1, provided that this T2 is greater than T1 and R2 is greater than R1. Providing this condition, for that condition we can write the relation for alpha is equal to R2 minus R1 divided by R1 into delta T. Same relation can also be written as, if you want to determine only change in resistance, that is R1 minus R2, then you can write here alpha into R1 into T2 minus T1. Or if you want to determine any resistance R2 for that particular T2 temperature, then value of R2 can be determined as R1 or 0 value R1 in bracket 1 plus alpha into T2 minus T1. By using these relations, we can determine value of R2. So this is a temperature of resistance, but at the same instant we have to distinguish these different materials, that is there is effect of temperature on conductor, there is effect of temperature on its alloys, and there is a effect of temperature on semiconductor devices, and their effect is used in many practical ways. That is, we have to here now consider a type of resistance which is known as thermistor. Here we have to think about